nigga, we gonna touch the green. We gonna get the oil. What kind of person you think? I don't know about that. Shit. He put himself in a situation, and we gotta be very careful, sons of God, because we want the devil. No. You put yourself in that situation because you knew better, and he knew better. Ahab knew better. The Bible says he sold himself to do evil. So I'm not surprised at the R. Kelly's. I'm not surprised at a lot of these people. They just starting to catch up. The old fool, you say your sin will find you out.
Amen.
You keep doing it. Keep thinking these people. You keep thinking Donald Trump and the rest. You keep thinking all these people walk around acting crazy. You think they're gonna keep getting away with it? Sooner or later, like the old fool say, you gotta pay the piper. Sooner or later, it's coming back. Well, I don't believe in your God. You don't have to. Make your mind up, say about God, about the God you serve.
That's right.
You don't have to do you have to believe in grammar before it take it? Let me show you something. It ain't predicated on your belief. God's word is God's word, and that's it.
Amen.
It don't matter what they individually believe. People think, oh, I have to believe. You don't have to believe it. The Bible says in Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. Wage means pocket money. Sin wants to get paid.
Oh my God.
But the Bible says he sold himself to do evil. Those who covet never find peace. I'm praying to say, those who covet never find peace, always longing for something they don't have. But those who are at peace focus more on what they do have so they can find peace in life. People that ain't at peace, they always focusing on something else. They mind just, it just want, like they say, it just wanders all over the place. Matthew 13, we bring this in. Matthew 13, I gotta get to this. 21 says this. Yet he has no firm root in himself, but is only temporary. And when affliction or persecution arises because of the word, immediately he falls away, has no root. The one among the thorns, the cares of this world, is the carnal one, the worldly comfort, who never really breaks with their past. And this particular text was going on, just to give you a brief synopsis of what's going on in this particular part of the text. Basically, it was talking about the different types of soils. Some soils that are stony, some soils that are weedy, some soils that are rocky. But this particular person has no root. When the cares of the world rise up, it chokes everything out of them. That's why David said in Psalms 119:11, thy word have I hid in my heart. So you can't just rely on Sunday and Thursday just to get it. No, you gotta fill up every day. Come on, say something. You gotta bathe yourself in prayer. You gotta get in your word. Come on, say something. You just can't wait for a moment. Every moment you get a chance to seize God's word. Do you see what's going on in the atmosphere? Do you see what's going on in the world? Do you see what's going on in the government? Do you think it's going to get better? No, it's not going to get better. Dangerous connections. I don't know if you know this, but a lot of businesses now are connected and conjoining themselves. Phone companies are conjoining themselves. I got two banks, SunTrust and BBT. They already been official, but they just haven't really became official public to the point where they're one entity now. But in February, they're gonna be one entity. Banks are coming. Do you think they just coming together just to come together? Because one ain't had no, they ain't had enough money, so they don't come together with this one? Not many people do that. Things are coming together for a reason, says God. Banks are coming together, phone companies are coming together, cable companies coming. It don't matter which one you go with, because they both are crazy as a bad bug anyway. And all they're gonna do is to give you the runaround. I ain't going to AT&T, I'm gonna go to Spectrum. It don't matter. Oh, I'm going to Verizon. Oh, I'm going to T-Mobile. Then you find out T-Mobile is Simple Mobile. You find out T-Mobile is Sprint Talk. You find out T-Mobile is Metro. They done monopolize the whole market. So you done cussed T-Mobile out. Told you I ain't coming back to y'all. I'm going somewhere else. And the somewhere else you going, get with, you still paying T-Mobile. Because the world knows this. The world knows. That's why we got to make sure our soil with our hearts is till, so when the seeds fall, it produces something. See, we see what the world is producing because the seeds had already fallen. And their hearts was already tilled for the certain seeds that came. So when the seeds came a few years ago, that's why it's no surprise. Not as a surprise to some, because we experienced things even on our job, but we didn't know that hatred was still at an all-time high, because some of your best friends don't it's not your persuasion, not your color, or not from your ethnicity. But when certain things arise and happen in time, we noticed that they still was took you out to lunch and you still can't believe it. Had you over your house and you still can't believe it. You got even people on the news talking about they don't even want certain people coming to their restaurant. It's just foolishness, because they fall into a persuasion. It's so deeply rooted. They're so rooted in evil that they don't mind using the N-word. They don't mind cutting you off. They don't mind shooting you on the highway because they felt like you cut them off. They don't mind because they sold themselves to evil. They're slaves to the enemy. They're children of the bondwoman. They allowed themselves to be like Ahab.
All right.
They allowed themselves to be like Samson. But the story ends with both of them. And I want you to go back and read it. But Ahab, the Bible said, when he got to a point, he put himself in sackcloth and ashes. And he told the prophet, God told the prophet, he said, look at Ahab, how he has humbled himself before the Lord. And because he had humbled himself, the calamity that's going to come on his household is going to happen after when he died. Same thing with Samson. God allowed Samson to regain the strength, the Bible said, and his hair began to grow again. That was representation of basically God brought restoration to Samson. So in spite of how far he went off to the left, when Samson prayed and asked God just to give him one more chance to be able to avenge himself, he sat himself between two pillars and asked the young man just to prop me up. And the Bible says he pushed the pillars, and Samson killed more in that one setting than his whole tenure when he judged the children of Israel. Says to God, be careful of the connections you made. The power of persuasion is real. Don't take it lightly. Don't take it for granted. It ain't just about dating. It ain't just about work relations. Because you can do business relations, still ain't good. It may be good on the surface. It may be good for the deal. But it may not be good long term. It may be good to a point where it benefits you, your family, and your kids. But it may cause detriment to somebody else. It may cause harm to somebody else. Later on, you'll be surprised at the deals that have been made. That was a benefit to many people in their family, financially. If you're just looking at it from the finance, it'll do some things. But look at all the other things it does. Look at all the other people. It keep them with low wages and low jobs and low this. And see, everybody don't want to go to college. Some people like trades, or some people like other pieces of commerce or business, and they do well at it. So why not pay them? Because number one, you don't want to sweep the floor. So why are we underpaying the people that's the hostess and people that work at the hotels and look down on them? You don't look down on them when you want clean bed sheets. That somebody else was slept on and did their business on, and now you want clean bed sheets and you want clean pillowcase. We ought to be, I ought to be one of the top people. They get paid. Because I know what me and my wife, when we stay somewhere, I want the stuff to be clean. Because if I see something and we already come in here, I don't even know why we even come. Because we come in, we just redo the whole the bedroom anyway. We spray everything, sanitize everything down real good. We ought to clean the bathroom. Why? Because we want to be clean.
Amen.
We ain't to worry about COVID, because we were doing that long before COVID. And says God, don't be so worried to the point, even with COVID and variants and different things. Wait for the next one. Wait for the next one. You think COVID is bad. See, God allowed us to bypass Ebola. Ebola was worse than COVID. It's just that, you know, we didn't get as strong as COVID did with the normal thing. But as soon as one person came over here with Ebola, boy, our antenna went way up. We were sanitized. Because we know it's a flesh-eating disease.
Yes.
See, we ain't talking about something that's attacking your respiratory and causing you where you can't breathe. We're talking about something that put tumors and inside tumors on you and cause your skin to decay and cause your skin to erode and eat away. Don't be so hung up on these things, things of God. The power of persuasion is real. Let us stand. I pray that somebody will be blessed today.
Amen.
All right. Good morning. Again, to our I'm not even calling you y'all visitors. Again, to our family, because y'all are safe. Y'all are safe.
Amen.
Thank God. Again, to our family, our extended family. Amen. We want to say thank you for coming in and allowing yourself to worship with us and be a part of our worship experience. Again, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you.